it's almost like the contracts, you know, are the new slave chains, right? So, you know, you have to sign this contract and sign this document and sign this document. It's like you're binded to this. And then if you break that, that's your livelihood. That's your life. So we the new slaves. Athletes are literally the new slaves because we need this. Our families, our friends depend on this contract to eat.
They say they want you to be an animal out there. And you want to give them that. But let me tell you something. What they don't want you to understand is what's being established is a power dynamic. Before they put you on the field, teams poke, prod, and examine you, searching for any defect that might affect your performance. No boundary respected. No dignity left intact.
Come on, boy, hurry up. Look at that shape there. Look at this.
500, 600,
right here. Look at this here. Come on, who wants this?
So, and you know, the majority of the owners of the NFL are white men. The majority of the players are black men. So there is that comparison that he makes to slave owners and slaves is not sort of totally unreasonable.
You got to interview him for Ebony.
I did.
And Colin said this: I am still up at 5 a.m. training 5-6 days a week, making sure I'm prepared to take a team to the Super Bowl again. That's not something I will ever let go of.
And he loves the sport, but the white owners have prevented him from doing it. They've colluded and they have the power. They have all the power to prevent him from doing the one thing that he loves.
If they
believe
he
could win them a Super Bowl, he would be on a team right now. I promise you that. I think a lot of people
disagree with that. If they believe he win a Super Bowl, he would be on a team right now.
We're not going to win a Super Bowl.
We will not win a Super Bowl for you, but we will keep you informed of what's going on in the world. We'll be right back.